So I'm usually a pretty big wuss when it comes to horror movies, but with it being October and Halloween coming up, I thought I would branch out and watch some of them. So today I'm going to watch the 1974 film The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I'm very nervous to watch this. Obviously, anything with massacre in the title sounds terrifying, so I'm not sure if this will be more of a slasher film, if we'll get to know a backstory or anything like that, but my prediction is that it will be very gory, just again with massacre in the title and chainsaw. Usually those two things, you know, lead to a pretty intense situation. Thank you so much for sharing in this first time watching with me. If you have any other suggestions for movies you think I should watch, please comment below. And I do have horror movie themed notebooks. The link will be below. And if you want to have a say in what movies or TV shows I watch, be sure to join Patreon. And as always, please like, comment, and subscribe to this channel and check back often for more awesome content.
In the annals of American history, the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Is this based on a true story or anything like that? Sounds terrifying with that intro.
Evidence linking the crime to elements outside the state. Area residents have reportedly...
That's terrifying.
Fearing the remains of relatives have been removed.
They dug up some bodies and like posed them on this monument like this? Like... Yeah, and they said it might not all be pieces from different bodies. Like, those legs looked like they were way too long for that first body.
Jumped from the 10th story window of his apartment. A second man allegedly threatened to leave his death.
Oh, okay, Tobe Hooper again? Okay. I've been seeing more of his stuff recently. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm curious if this is a true story or based on a book or anything like that. Yeah, and that's interesting having, like, the news report playing in the background of all these events that are going on, and I'm wondering, like, this information be relevant later, or is this just, like, setting the scene that something horrible is gonna happen?
Look!
It's his wallet made out of a squirrel.
I was the killer!
He took pictures of it?
They don't send the heads away.
Are
they saying they killed cattle with a sledgehammer to the head?
See, they make...
And he took photos? I'm very concerned. No, 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 please don't. Oh, God.
What are you doing to yourself? Oh, my God.
Oh, that's awful. He's just cutting his own hand with his knife. Maybe let's keep sharp objects away for a little while.
I have this knife!
That's like a barber. Like a shaving blade. He's like, please keep it away from me. Please, 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 no more. Let's not share knives. Is that gunpowder? He's gonna set it on fire. Yeah, he's gonna set it on fire. Oh my God. No! Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh! Oh my God! I hope they got lots of gas in that van.
I got no gas.
You're out of gas?
Trouble number one. Run out of gas. It's kind of reminding me of The Hills Have Eyes, the 70s Wes Craven one.
An old house.
Bitch. Just with like a road trip that I'm assuming is going to go awry, and that's what it said in the intro as well. It was like it was supposed to just be this road trip and then horrible things happened. But yeah, there's they're running out of gas and they're like, you can stay and wait for the transport truck to show up, but...
I'll go in.
Texas is a big state, so it might be a while. Yeah, he put like a bloody handprint or something on the van. Yeah, I like these really long, wide shots showing like the landscape.
Thank you.
And I don't understand why if they're out of gas, they're going somewhere even like, more secluded.
Yes, before we get back to that service station, you told us back in your chair.
Instead of going to the next gas station first, or... They think they have enough gas to get to this house and get back to the gas station, but I guess we'll find out.
Come on, sir.
Yeah, it's not just like a handprint, like it looks like a distinct mark.
We'll see you in about an hour or so.
Famous last words. Yeah, there's like an animal carcass, but it looked like it was on like a pillow. Everybody knows, as soon as you break off from the group, you're doomed.
I never get down here anyway.
Somebody must have carried him when he was little.
Oh yeah, the riverbed's all dried up, I'm guessing. It looks hot. I haven't been to Texas in the middle of the summer, but I imagine it gets quite warm.
I can leave him my guitar, you know, give him a couple.
Like, and that you can, like, the sound and, like, yeah, like, this, yeah, it feels like the middle of the day. It just feels, like, hot out. Like, it just feels like just that, like, stale summer heat. Yeah, they're like, oh, we hear a noise. They thought it was gas. It sounds like a generator, but there's also just, like, a pile of cars that have been left running. Yeah, okay, it is a generator. A tooth? Where did that tooth come from? Usually they don't just fall out of the sky.
Hello?
Is he like hoping he can ask them if they can borrow some gas or something?
Hello?
Well, that might be the world's largest collection of dead animals on the wall. Cheese and rice, he's running out of space. Gonna need a bigger house soon.
Hey, Pam!
What was that? Why is there like squealing pig sounds? Oh my god! 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 He's killing him like they were killing the cows at the slaughterhouse. Like he just bashed him over the head. And this like really low angle shot that seems to be only when the female characters are on screen. Yeah, what the frick? It looked like a door for like a freezer, like an industrial freezer, like this like sheet metal door almost. I'm very worried. Pam's next. And there's like feathers all over the floor. Oh my god. Oh, so many bones and teeth. That looks human. Okay, nightmare. Oh. It's like one head tied and like all these other random bones connected and look like they were tied to the chair and they're just hanging from the ceiling. Just like cages and cages of bones that some look human, some look animal. I don't know. It must have just been like so creepy to collect all this stuff for the set and for the props. And you're like, what do you need? Oh, about 1 trillion bazillion bones. Oh God, no, no, no. He's gonna put her on a meat hook like an animal. No, 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 no. Oh God, I can feel it. I can feel it happening. Is she hanging by her clothes or did he actually go like in her skin? Oh great, the chainsaw, title of the movie. What does he have on his face? Like he has a mask on?
He's gonna get you, Franklin. He's coming to get you.
Oh my god, what was that? Can you imagine watching your boyfriend just getting slowly, like, oh my god, that's horrifying.
It's our friend.
No, no, run away. Your friends are in there, but probably in a million pieces by now, thanks to that chainsaw.
Damn.
Yeah, and it seems like this house is relatively close to Sally and Franklin's, like, old family house. So I'm wondering if the two families, like, knew each other at some point. Are they somehow connected? Because they literally look like they're, like, next-door neighbors. How is this place not setting off red flags? They're in the freezer? Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Oh, bonked him. He's like, how do people just keep showing up at my house? I don't lock the doors or anything, but people keep walking in. Yeah, and he hasn't said anything. Like, he's just making these noises. Oh, poor chicken. He's seen some things. Yeah, like, what is his mask, like, made of? Like, it's just, like... And he added eyebrows to, like, the outside of his mask. Like, what?
Sally? Sally, why you made it?
Oh, the battery's gonna be dead if you leave the lights on, too, if you ever make it back. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Yeah, and if they're... It sounds like they used to visit this house, but not very often, so... I'm curious at how much they remember, if they would know who's supposed to live in that house. Because, yeah, it looks like they're the closest house.
Hey, Jay!
Jay!
Yeah, like, I feel like they're yelling pretty loudly. If you were anywhere, like, close by, you'd definitely be able to hear them. But obviously, we know Jerry met a different fate. Oh, my God! Oh, my God! Oh, my God! Oh my god! Bye, Franklin! Oh my god! Oh my god! My heart! He's like, oh, I hear something! Stop! And then, of course, as soon as you stop, this guy walks out. Cheese and rice! At least you can hear the chainsaw coming, but oh my god, run! He's like, get out of my way, stupid branches. I would not feel confident running with a chainsaw in the first place in a dark, wooded area. Slips, trips, and falls. That would be just like, what do you do? Like, you don't have the keys, even if you make it back to the car. You're in like a rural area. She's just hiding under these trees to hope he can't get to her, but I mean... He does have a chainsaw. That's, yeah, and of course she's gonna run into the house. So he's like, perfect, that's exactly where I want you to go. She thinks she's running into safety. It's like, you're gonna lock me out of my own house? I don't think so. It kind of looks like the house from, Night of the Living Dead. Okay, it's your own front door, but you know, sure. What is this room? He has a mask like this guy does? What? Are these all the people he robbed from graves? Yep. Oh god! Oh my god. That seemed very painful. I would have broken myself for sure. Cheese and rice. She wants to live, that's for sure. This has been a, like a long sequence of being chased and like... She discovered, yeah, whoever was upstairs. Yeah, like, what's in that case, and why did he stop coming in? Oh, of course you're gonna leave the door open.
Only the heads and extremities are removed, and others in which only a hand or foot is
removed. What? What was in there? Maldonado and Hitch- Was that, like, human parts? Oh my god, lady, don't get in this truck. I have a bad feeling.
He declined to suggest any reason for the thieves.
What kind of- Aw, no phone, come on, man. Why is he, like, smiling? Like, why is he so happy?
There's no need to do that. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Oh, my God. The broom? Come on. Ah, come on. He's swatting her like a fly. So rude. Of course, the one place she would go for, like, some help, turns out to be a prick. What kind of sicko is this? He's like, aha, so fun, ha ha ha, let me hit you with my broom. Ew, oh god, there's already blood on it, no. Is this guy, like, somehow connected to that other guy? Like, he stopped when she went in there and, like, didn't seem concerned. I don't know that he would give up that easily after chasing her around for forever.
I hope you're not too uncomfortable down there.
Like, you actually give a crap about her comfort levels. Let's, come on, honestly. She's screaming her head off.
There's no need to do that, though.
He's like laughing at her pain. He's like, oh, you're suffering. That's so funny to me. Like, just so sick. So twisted. Yeah, and he had like the biggest smile on his face when she was crying.
Wait.
Oh, the hitchhiker that they saw before. Yeah.
You're an idiot. Where are you going?
Oh my god, he just loves beating people with this broom. Okay, so this hitchhiker's brother's with this guy. Is he wearing a fur hat now? Oh, he put a wig on? Grandpa? Is that who they dug up from the graveyard? That guy in the chair?
We'll have something right away.
You gotta get out of there. There's no way they're gonna let you go, man. You gotta get out of there and run. Cheese and rice. What? He's alive? What? What? He's like sucking the blood off her finger? What? What? He's alive? What is happening here? Yeah, exactly. Oh my god. Oh god, that extreme close up and then extreme zoom out. Got like hands on the arms of that chair? And a literal head for a lamp?
Having fun!
Or like they put like skin on the outside of a lamp?
Please!
They're treating their house like their own personal slaughterhouse.
Shut up, you bitch hog!
Is this their uncle or their dad or their something? I don't know. This is a nightmare. Nightmare fuel. I'm terrified to think of where all the women in this family have gone. Yeah, if these two are brothers. Oh my god. Yeah, these like really extreme close-ups. I could, like, he's just taunting her crying and like taunting her pain. Did they like dye or like put color contacts in or something? It looked like she had green like at the bottom of her eye, yeah.
Oh, need to torture the poor girl.
What do you think you're doing? Like, this is torture.
Get on with it. I won't have this.
Yeah, like, you're so above all of this. You're the one beating her senses with a broomstick and took her here. That's so, like, disorientating. Yeah, these, like, super close-up shots and, like, scratching metal sound. Oh. Okay, he's cutting you loose. Get out of there. You should be able to overpower Grandpa.
No!
This poor girl, I don't know how she didn't lose her voice during filming. I feel like she's been screaming for the past 30 minutes. Oh my god, they're gonna put her head in this bucket. Grandpa ain't what he used to be. This could take a while. Oh! This whole family is just like so twisted. Yeah, get out of there, girl. Your hands are free. Run. Second window. Okay. And now it's daytime? That other scene definitely looked like it was nighttime. Run. Or they just had all the windows closed and boarded up. Yeah, get out of there. Oh my god. And of course, yeah, there's no, it's, if like you're not like in a city or anything where there's people nearby, you're all out in the middle of the woods or in the middle of like the farm. I hope there's a car. Please let there be a car coming by. What is he doing? Like cutting her while she's running? Okay, well. She's literally covered in blood. Oh, he's like, you know what? Forget this. You got a chainsaw. Okay, get in there. Get in there. Hurry. Why is on foot the better option? Oh, bonked him right in the head with a wrench. Oh my God. Oh, he cut his own leg. Oh. There actually hasn't been that much like gore. Like it's been a lot of like off camera stuff so far. Now, of course, the car won't start. Get out of there! Well, I hope this guy's not a psycho. Oh, cheese and rice. That scared me. She's lost it. I don't blame her. He's so mad. It's like, this chainsaw's my only toy. That was unsettling. Deeply, deeply disturbing. Leatherface. Okay, I definitely have heard that character's name before. So, okay. I was wondering, yeah, because I didn't think they said his name very often. I did not think she was getting away. So that was my first time watching the 1974 film, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. It was pretty intense. I wasn't expecting Sally to get away at the end. I thought for sure that she was doomed. They definitely seemed very dedicated to killing her like they had killed everybody else. Even when we see her run out into the middle of the road, the truck driver is like, oh, I'll help you. And then as soon as he sees that she's being chased by a guy with a chainsaw, he's like, you know what? Just kidding. And then luckily that pickup truck pulls up and she's able to jump in the back. And we see that last final shot of her like, you know, Nick Cage and Mandy, like, covered in blood, like, laugh crying, basically, as she's being taken away, and I think just kind of realizes, oh my God, I'm doing it, like, I'm alive, I'm somehow escaping, and hopefully that guy actually takes her to the police or somewhere safe, and come back to this house with some police officers and get her friends, and like, yeah, I hope that's what happens. They didn't show that, obviously, but I'm hoping that's the next sequence of events. I don't know if there are sequels or remakes or anything like that, with Sally surviving. I don't know if they kept it open for a possible sequel, but yeah, I'd be very curious to see what would happen again. And yeah, I'm curious if Sally and Franklin's family would have known this other family, since like they seem like they were like next door neighbors, and it doesn't sound like Sally and Franklin visited their family house very often, but I wonder if her relatives would have known the family next door, or if they've always had a reputation of like, don't go over to those people's house, you know, there's something off about them. So yeah, I was very curious to see if they would have made that connection. It's definitely a slasher film. We didn't really learn the backstory of anybody other than that Sally and Franklin, this is used to be their family house. And even the characters' names, like Hitchhiker, Old Man, Leatherface, like I wish we would have learned a little bit more about them, as twisted as it would have been, just something to help kind of give their character some depth, to maybe explain why they're like this and anything like that. I don't know. We had that intro opening text, so I don't know if this is based on a true story or anything like that. So comment below and let me know. For a movie with the title Massacre in the title, we didn't see that much gore or blood. There was that shot where Leatherface cuts his leg that we see at the very end, but even that's like a very quick shot and like nothing crazy. And then we see Sally's head when she gets hit on the head. There's blood there, but yeah, it wasn't. I was honestly expecting like floor to ceiling, like just buckets and buckets of blood and just extreme. It was definitely very violent, but not as much gore. And even a lot of the stuff happened off camera, like when we see Leatherface is cutting up Kirk, we can't see what's happening. We can see him taking the chainsaw to his body, obviously, but we don't see like the actual, they don't punch in for that close-up shot of like the chainsaw going through his skin or anything like that. And even when he hangs up Pam on that meat hook, we don't really, like the hook doesn't seem to come through her. I thought maybe it was just holding up her clothing, like it didn't look like it was injuring her. I thought that's how he was gonna kill her, was to put it on this meat hook basically. So yeah, it was definitely still very intense and very disturbing and just a lot of unsettling things and just they were robbing these graves and then taking their bones back to their family. I honestly thought the grandfather character was dead because he didn't look like he was doing very well, and he was up in that other room. So I thought they had like stolen his grave from the graveyard, as there had been obviously reported grave robbings in the area, and that's what these guys were doing. But then when we see him try and like suck the blood off of Sally's finger, it's just so gross, and just like, I was not expecting him to be alive. And we found out that Leatherface and the Hitchhiker were brothers, but I don't know how that gas station attendant guy was, if he's their uncle, if he's their dad, I'm not too sure. It seemed like Leatherface was almost afraid of him because he was being really rude to him, and he was kind of like cowering a little bit, even though he was much bigger than this gas station guy. He was like kind of like still nervous when he was around. And considering Leatherface was our main villain in this movie, he didn't say anything. He definitely made noises and had like different sounds and stuff, but he didn't say a single sentence. And yeah, so that was interesting, I find. Like, he just conveyed all his feelings kind of like an animal. And even when they first go into the house, it sounds like there's like pig squealing sounds. And then we see him kill, as they had talked about, killing animals in the slaughterhouse. So I don't know if he once worked at the slaughterhouse, if he's just from this community and knows that this is what they do. I don't know if Leatherface just never learned to talk, or if he didn't go to school, or if, you know, nobody took the time to teach him or anything like that. So, or if he just chooses not to. We didn't get to see his actual face, as he wore the mask for the whole time, and then seemed like he had even like a few different versions of masks. Like at the end when he comes running down the driveway, and he's wearing like really bright makeup and that wig. So yeah, I'm not too sure if what's underneath the mask is something he's trying to hide, or if he just likes wearing these masks. And that dinner scene when you see like the light bulb, it looks like it has skin over it, like they took somebody's like skin off their face and used it as like a lampshade, like just so disturbing. It definitely reminded me of The Hills Have Eyes, the Wes Craven one. And when we see they go out to this gas station, there's no gas. Okay, well now you're stuck here. And then people are killed off one by one. And it also kind of reminded me of House of a Thousand Corpses, as they, I believe there's a dinner scene in that. I honestly haven't seen it since I watched it when it came out, and that terrified me. So I have like a vague memory of a dinner scene from that movie and people being turned into very horrible things. But I believe that was also like one family that was conducting this stuff. I really liked the cinematography. I thought that was interesting, when we had like these really long shots of like the Texas landscape, and when we see them like running through the woods at night. And even when Leatherface is coming down the driveway again, it's like this really long scene, and they're trying to show like how isolated they are. And like I said, if you were, you know, downtown in a city or something like that, people would see this. And but of course he's out in the country, so he has more freedom to do these things, as not many people are around. I was honestly not expecting any cars to come onto that road, but luckily some did. And then when we had Sally being tortured, and she's at that dinner scene, and we've got those really, really extreme close-ups, like I couldn't imagine seeing that on a big screen, how jarring that would be, just because we're not used to it. And I think especially in 1974, it would be something unexpected. And we have just like the super extreme close-up of her eye, like it starts off with a close-up of her face and then gets closer and closer and closer, and you just see these like wide eyes, like panicked, like scanning the room hoping somebody's gonna show up and help her, and that hopefully she can get out of this. And when they cut her hands from that chair, and that chair that had arms made out of human arms, like, oh my god, just so disturbing. And basically they were just using like human body parts for their furniture and to like decorate, and just, it was so bizarre. And even that gas station guy was like, oh, I don't want to be involved in this stuff, like this isn't for me, you know, you do the killing, I don't want to be involved. And then goes back to like laughing maniacally when they're about to hurt her. And just such a very dark, sick, and like so twisted. It was directed and produced by Tobe Hooper, and I've just watched Poltergeist, so I've seen that, and Life Force as well, so I'm starting to see more and more of his films. I didn't recognize any of the cast members, so comment below, did they go on to do other horror movies? I don't know if this was like a bigger budget one or if this was a pretty indie film, but yeah, I didn't recognize any of the cast, and especially Leatherface, obviously we didn't really get to see what the actor looked like underneath the mask. I don't don't know if the actor who played Leatherface continued to play this, if there is sequels or anything like that. Please no spoilers, but yeah, I feel like this would be a very intense role to be associated with. It's like Freddy Krueger, or even like Jason is played by different people. I think doing like set or props for the show would have been very intense because you're dealing with such dark subject matter and bones all the time and skulls and like all these animal carcasses. And I don't know if they sourced real ones, if they tried to make fake ones. There was one hand that they had hanging from the ceiling that looked like a little bit of like a Halloween decoration. For the most part, all that stuff looked pretty legitimate. So yeah, I just, it's intense to think about having to, because there was a lot, like that whole room was just, the whole house was completely like decorated. And that was our main set. Like it was pretty much this set, and then the van is where we spent most of the time, and the gas station, but that was pretty much it. And obviously with like a smaller cast and most of them not making it, you know, halfway through the movie. Even when they arrive at the gas station, we find out later that the gas station guy is, you know, connected to Leatherface and the Hitchhiker. And when he sees that mark on the van, he's like, oh, we're out of gas. And I'm like, are you actually out of gas? Are you just trying to set them up so that they're stranded here, obviously? And even when Sally comes in, he's like, I need to use your phone. He's like, we don't have a phone. Like, I don't know how accurate that is, or if he was just lying to her so that she couldn't call the police and get away. And obviously, we saw he wanted to keep her there and comes back grinning like it's Christmas Eve, basically, with this freaking sack and rope. And he's like, oh, we're gonna have some fun now. Watch me beat you over the head with my broom. Like, just so twisted. So obviously, if they didn't pick up the hitchhiker, it would have been a very short movie if they would have just kept driving and probably made it to a different gas station. I think that mark on the van signed their fate, basically. And even if they had kept the hitchhiker with them and they got into the gas station, like, the hitchhiker and the gas station guy obviously know each other, so it's not like they would have been safe from that either way. They would have just probably ended up at that house sooner. And obviously, if Sally and her friends had agreed to go back with the hitchhiker to dinner at his place, like he originally invited them, was like, yeah, come over for dinner, you know, like, we all know what would have happened at that dinner. I wasn't expecting the hitchhiker to be the catalyst for this fate. So I wonder how many people who were, because this came out in the 70s, how many people stopped hitchhiking or stopped picking up hitchhikers because they saw this, because they were afraid of who was going to get in the car with them. I don't know how popular hitchhiking is currently, and obviously if this would have taken place in current day, cell phones and technology would have been, I'm sure in the movie they would have failed, because that's always what happens. But yeah, given that the time that this came out, like, she has to try and track down a phone and nobody really knows where they are, and who knows the last time they even like checked in with somebody, and obviously the car doesn't have like GPS or any of those pieces. So I can't imagine how terrifying this would have been to watch on the big screen when it first came out. And especially seeing all those close-ups of Sally's face, and even the sound design. There was only a few songs we heard on the van radio at the start of the film, and then just like the sound of that chainsaw starting was just terrifying. Overall, I thought it was super creepy and just so bizarre, and just the fact that somebody's chasing you with a chainsaw, and you know, you're out in the middle of nowhere, and he has like this mask. Like, even if you go to the police and say like, oh, he looks like this, like he had a gray wig and was wearing makeup, and they're just gonna be like, what are you talking about? Like, just so bizarre. I'm glad Sally lived, our final girl. I'm glad she made it out alive. I did not think she would. For a movie with the name Chainsaw Massacre in its title, I was definitely expecting a lot more blood, a lot more gore. I'm not sad that those things didn't happen, but that's how I'd kind of set it up in my mind. If they just didn't have the budget for that, or if they wanted a different rating or anything, there wasn't any like sex scenes, there wasn't a ton of swearing. So yeah, I'm curious to find out what this was rated. But thank you so much for sharing in this first time watching with me. If you have any other suggestions for horror movies you think I should watch, please comment below. And as always, please like, comment, and subscribe to this channel, and check back often for more awesome content.
This is wallet made out of a squirrel. Put like a bloody handprint or something on the van. Where did that tooth come from? Why is there like squealing pig sound? And there's like feathers all over the floor? Like, is a mask on? He's like, how do people just keep showing up at my house? He does have a chainsaw. And a broom. A literal head for a lamp. To be able to overpower grandpa. Punked him right in the head with a wrench.